51?
51 numbers on mine.
Anybody able to speak of some lines in the song so they know where that song is?
Lord is my light, my salvation. I took my life. 27 number song. I will adore the Lord at all times. His praise and can be in my mouth. 34 number song.
Cast your burden upon the Lord.
Talking about the weakness.
It's all for your body.
So warm, that may be.
What'd you say?
I was looking here, and I kept looking at the book, and kept referring to 2 Samuel 22. And it's interesting what it says. It says, "For I have kept the ways of the Lord. I have not turned from my God to follow evil." He did evil, but he kept the ways of the Lord. He didn't let the evil turn him away from God.
You notice that in David's whole life, God called him a man after his own heart, even though he did a bunch of sin. Big thing. You know about Bathsheba. That time, he took a census when he wasn't supposed to. All these things David did. Matter of fact, when David took that census, it started people getting killed. God sent an angel to start killing the people of Israel. And David couldn't take it anymore. He said, "Wait a second, Lord. No, 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 me." And he took it. God looked at the angel and said, "It is enough. Stop." Why? Because it starts with leadership. It starts with leadership. It starts with leadership. David refers to himself as the sweet psalmist of Israel. Why? Most of the book of Psalms are his. Some are Solomon's. At least one is Moses that we know of. Some are from the sons of Asaph, some from the sons of Korah. You read the Psalms, look at the emotion that's coming out of it. There's nothing wrong with being emotional in church. There's nothing wrong with shouting. There's nothing wrong with praising Him in the dance. All of that is wonderful. We are supposed to be subdued. We're supposed to shout to the Lord with a voice of triumph. We lift our hands. It's called praising the Lord. When we shout, that's Shabbat, that's the shout of praise that steals the Avengers, keeps Satan out your life. And then we use our God-given rights. One of them was to shackle him and put him in fetters. Psalm 149. It's a war song, but it's also a hallelujah song. Psalm 150, which we'll get at the end of this week, you know, tells us the ways to praise the Lord. On the instruments, with the dance, with the shout, with the song, with the clapping of the hands.
And dancing caused him his first marriage, didn't it? And Michael, then she divorced him because he was praising and ran, praised out of his clothes?
Exactly, yeah. a message about that. He said, I'm in love with the scripture.
Huh.
Why? Because David danced until everything fell off. He had nothing on him but his underwear. He said, didn't the king and then Michael for herself, what did she do? Got all jealous, started hating. And folks gonna hate on you if you praise the Lord. They gonna say, y'all go to church too much. You don't do nothing but listen to gospel music in the house. That's our prerogative. If you wanna listen to Jay-Z and Beyonce and Riri and all that, that's you. But if I want to hear some hip hop, I would put on some Gospel Gangsta, Sister Kirk Franklin. If I want to listen to some praise and worship, I'll put on some Dr. Franklin. If I want to hear some straight up gospel, I'll put some Chicago Mass Choir on, or something like that. Colorado Mass Choir, something like that. Shirley Caesar. It all depends on the flow of the day, on what you want. And of course, the
Can I get a time? Close to that time? 7:01.
Right. It's 7. They take a break. Take a break and you go back.